In this video, you will learn how to change the WordPress pagination system to the Load More button. By clicking on the Load More button, more posts will be loaded. On the Category page, the Load More button will work in the same way. Here you can see the Load More button on the Shop page and Product Category page. This method is fully customizable, and at the end of this video, I will show you how to change the text and color of this button. Also, this method is fully compatible with all page builders, like Gutenberg or Elementor. Let me thank Ram Aslan for his suggestion to make this video. If you have any suggestions for future videos, write them down in the comment section and make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any videos. I deleted all the scripts. Let's start over. Go to the link in the description. Copy this PHP code. On the WordPress dashboard, go to Appearance, Theme File Editor, and open the functions.php file. You can paste the copied code here. Since some of you guys had problems with this part, we use an alternative method. Go to the plugin menu and select Add New. Search for the Code Snippets plugin here and install and activate it. After activating this plugin, click on Add New from the Snippets menu. Enter a name for this code. Paste the copied code. Make sure that this code will be inserted only in the front end, and then click the Save and Activate button. If you go to the blog page now, you will not see any changes. At this stage, we should customize this script and insert it into our pages. To do this, you can either manually put this code on the page by the custom HTML block, or you can do it programmatically. You can read this post to get more information about how to insert scripts on desired pages. I will put the link to this post in the video description. To add the Load More button to the post archive pages, first copy this code. Now we have to find these four variables. If you know a little bit of CSS, this is very simple. If you don't worry. Here I will fully explain how to find these variables. Go to the post archive page, right-click and select Inspect. Here we need to find the container that wraps all of the posts. As you can see, all the posts are inside a div tag with an entries class. Therefore, the first variable is div.entries. Each post is inside an article tag, and each article tag has many classes. We only select classes that are the same in all articles. Here we select only the entry card class, which is the same among all article tags. When choosing the pagination container, make sure that it includes all the page numbers and the next button. This section will be hidden by our script. As you can see, this part is a nav tag with a CT pagination class. The next button has two classes, we only use the first one. It's done! Now we paste it at the bottom of the previous script. By refreshing the archive page, you will notice that the Load More button has been successfully added to this page. You can see that the Load More button is also activated on the category and tag pages. To activate the Load More button on the shop page, go to the link in the description again. Copy this PHP code. As before, we have to find these four variables and write them in the script. Right-click and select Inspect. As you can see, all the products are inside a UL tag with a Products class. Each product is inside a LI tag, and each LI tag has many classes. We only select classes that are the same in all of them. Here we select only the product class, which is the same among all article tags. The pagination wrapper is a nav tag with a CT pagination class. The next page button is an A tag with a next class. It's done! Now we copy this script and paste it at the bottom of the previous script. By refreshing the shop page, you will notice that the Load More button was successfully added to this page. You can see that the Load More button is also activated on the product category and tag pages. To change the text inside Load More button, go back to the code section and edit this part. Here I change the button text to show more. To change the color of this button, first copy the color code you want. Now go back to the code section and replace background color in the style tag with the new color code. Now I will replace this loader with the new loader that I uploaded earlier. I will copy this link and paste it in the correct format here. Please keep in mind that all of the changes we made affect both the post archive pages and the product archive pages. That's it. If you do have any questions or comments about this, please put them below. If you liked this video and would like to see more like it, please subscribe, and I'll see you next time.